how much do you know about the birth control pill? Like, really know about the birth control pill? Now, if you're a woman in the audience, you've probably heard the drill, right? You have an increased risk of stroke or weight gain, or, you know, you might get a risk of pulmonary embolism, especially if you're over 35 and smoke. Right, guys in the audience, you probably know that if your partner is on the pill, that it might spare you the cruel and unusual fate of having to wear a condom during sex, right? But like, how much do you know about the birth control pill when it comes to the part of our bodies that most of us care about more than any other, right? The brain. How much do we know about the birth control pill in the brain? Right now, asking this question is something that feels a little risky to a lot of women, right? And this is because to ask this question violates two rules of feminism that most of us adopt sort of unconsciously since childhood, right? And the first of these rules is do not criticize the birth control pill. Right? Women are, understandably, very protective of the birth control pill. Right? And the reason for this is that it's been absolutely amazing for women. Right? And just to illustrate this for you, if you look at this figure behind me, what you'll see is the proportion of female applicants to law and medical schools prior to the birth control pill being made legally available to single women. Right? They made up just 10% of the applicant pool. Flash forward 20 years later, and women are 50% of the applicant pool. By allowing women to regulate their fertility, right, and be able to plan, women made longer-term career goals, longer-term educational goals, and the birth control pill and all of the freedom it afforded us is responsible for so much of women's advancement in terms of being able to become financially independent from men. Right, and so the pill has been a really amazing force in the lives of women. And because of this, questioning or thinking critically about the birth control pill can scare people, right? Making them think that we'll have to go back to the time when women were financially dependent on men and lose some of our freedom. Right, despite the fact that knowledge is always powerful, right? And talking critically about the birth control pill doesn't mean that we have to give it up. The second rule that we get into trouble with when we want to talk critically about the birth control pill in the brain is the rule that tells us we absolutely cannot talk about sex hormone involvement in the brain if you're a woman, right? And the reason for this is that for a very long time, women were treated as overly emotional, less rational versions of men because of our changing sex hormones. Right, there was a lot of sexist rhetoric that said that women shouldn't possibly be able to hold important jobs, right, own land, or vote because our cyclically changing hormones just made us completely irrational, right, and therefore not, you know, not somebody who should be in these types of positions. Right, but this idea prevents us from being able to have thoughtful discussions about the pill, and they're also totally not backed up in science. Right, to start with, women's hormones change cyclically, but they're not unpredictable. They're not capricious or whimsical or fickle. If you tell me a woman's age and you tell me the first day of her last menstrual cycle, I'll be able to predict with an almost alarming amount of precision exactly what her sex hormones are doing at that moment. Right? If she's in the first half of her cycle, we'll find that the sex hormone estrogen is relatively high relative to levels of progesterone. And if it's the second half of the cycle, I can predict that progesterone levels are going to be relatively high relative to levels of estrogen. Right? So even though women's hormones change cyclically, they're not unpredictable and capricious. Men's primary sex hormone, testosterone, on the other hand, is a totally different story. Right, so we know from research that men's levels of testosterone change in response to age, time of day, whether or not he has children, whether or not he's just watched sports, whether or not he's passed weapons, like if you see a gun, that changes testosterone levels, the presence of attractive women, and a whole bunch of other stuff too. Okay, so if anybody's got capricious hormones, it's men, right? So the idea that our sex hormones influence our brain shouldn't be problematic, right? Women's hormones change and they influence women's behavior and how women think, feel, and what they do. Men's hormones change, and when they change, they also influence what men think, feel, and do, right? And we have to start having conversations about these things because not doing so is bad for women's health. Right, because we need to break these rules that have prevented us from having thoughtful conversations about the birth control pill and who it makes women. Right, because even though women take the birth control pill for a small number of targeted effects, right, it has an impact on women's bodies from head to toe, including the brain. Right, and the way that the birth control pill works is it changes women's levels of sex hormones. And even though we tend to think of our sex hormones as something that happens to us, right, like something that causes puberty and hair growth and places that we don't really want to talk about in polite company, our sex hormones are actually a key part of the signaling machinery that our brain uses to create the experience of being the person that we are. And so when we change women's sex hormones, we're actually changing the version of their brain that they are creating. Right? And there's a growing body of research in psychology and neuroscience that shows this to be true. Right? For example, just thinking about sexual functioning, right, which is something that we all think about a lot, right? We know from research that women who are on the birth control pill exhibit decreased sexual desire and decreased sexual functioning relative to their naturally cycling counterparts. And the reason for this has everything to do with a hormonal profile that's created by the birth control pill. The hormones that facilitate the sexual response in women and facilitate sexual desire are relatively high levels of estrogen and testosterone and lower levels of progesterone, right? Progesterone actually inhibits women's sexual desire. And the sex hormone profile on the birth control pill is essentially sexual anti-venom. Right, it's high levels of progesterone, a sexual inhibitor, right, and relatively low levels of estrogen and testosterone. And indeed, there's a lot of research indicating that women tend to have diminished libido on the birth control pill. But it's not just sexual desire, right, and women's desire for sex and their sexual responsiveness that changes in response to the birth control pill. Right, it can also influence who women are attracted to. Right? And this is also something that's influenced by the levels of sex hormones that are created by the birth control pill. Right? So we know now from decades of research that women's own levels of estrogen predict the amount of testosterone that they prefer in their partners. In other words, the sex hormone estrogen increases women's attunement to cues that have historically been linked to testosterone levels in men. This graph that you're looking at here is showing how women's own levels of estrogen predict testosterone preference. And what you can see from this is that estrogen loves testosterone, right? So women, when they have relatively high levels of estrogen, are really cued in to facial cues that are associated with masculinity, and this changes their preferences over the course of the cycle. Now, given that the birth control pill keeps levels of estrogen very low, we can make the prediction that women who are on the birth control pill should prefer as partners men who have fewer cues associated with testosterone preference. And that's exactly what we find. So research finds now that women who are on the birth control pill prefer partners with less masculine faces than do their naturally cycling peers. And this is something that is found both when women are identifying men that they would like to have as short-term sexual partners, and also the people that they'd like to have as long-term romantic partners, right? The research has also found that pill-taking women are actually choosing as partners men with less masculine faces relative to naturally cycling women. So they've done studies where they've brought in the partners of women who chose their partner, whether they were on or off of the birth control pill, took photographs of their faces, created facial composites, and they were able to actually look at the proportion of testosterone markers on the faces of men. And they found out that the pill-taking women, indeed, were choosing as partners men with fewer testosterone markers in their faces. Right, so the birth control pill might be changing the face of mate preferences. And it's not just sex and sex-related things, right? Sex and mating, it all makes sense that all of that should change in response to the birth control pill when we really think about the idea that it's changing women's sex hormones. But that's just scratching the surface, right? Because our sex hormones also influence the other hormones in our body, including those that are associated with our stress response. So stress is something we all know, right? You know stress, sitting in traffic, giving a TED talk in front of 1,000 people, right? Being on the business end of a wildebeest stampede, right? Daily things that happen to us. Whenever we're, always a wildebeest stampede, right? Anytime that we're encountering a stressor, no matter what it is, whether it's a TED talk or the wildebeest, generally within about 5 minutes, our body releases the stress hormone cortisol. Right, which tends to get kind of a bad rap because everybody associates it with stress, but cortisol isn't what causes stress. Life is what causes stress. Right, cortisol is actually part of the way that our body helps cope with stress. It dumps fat and sugar into our bloodstream so we can make a fast getaway, and it primes our brain for learning and memory, so that way if we encounter a similar situation in the future, we'll be better able to cope with it. Right? And because of this, when we're feeling stressed out, our body releases cortisol, unless you're on the birth control pill. So there's several decades of research now that shows that women who are on the birth control pill exhibit a blunted or altogether absent cortisol response to stress. Right? And this is something that's potentially really important, not only because this is the type of profile that we tend to see in people who've undergone trauma or have PTSD, but also because it can cause structural changes in the brain, decrease people's ability to cope with stress, cause problems with emotional regulation, and impair learning and memory. And there's some research now coming out about the birth control pill in each one of these processes that suggests that we might be seeing just these patterns in women who are on the birth control pill. Right? And it's not just individual women who are changed by the birth control pill. Right? Each woman lives in an interdependent web that includes her friends, her family members, her romantic partners, and her colleagues. And so when we change what women's sex hormones are doing, those changes are going to echo throughout the woman's body in ways that have a lot of effects on her system, but they're also going to echo throughout the world as women are interacting with other people and changing the face of the world. So it's time to throw out the old rules, right? And we need to start having more, not fewer, conversations about women's brains and the birth control pill. And this doesn't mean that we abandon the birth control pill, right? It's still going to be the best choice for a lot of women at certain points in their lives. It was my choice for over a decade, right? But it's time to put the power of information in the hands of women to let them know what trade-offs they're making with the birth control pill, so that way they can make informed choices about their health and who they most want to be. Thank you.